Hi, and welcome to Healthitarian Living. On this episode, I will be sharing with you how to make raw homemade applesauce, something you can whip up literally within just a few minutes, assuming you have some fresh apples on hand. From the late summer season all throughout the fall, it's apple season. And there's nothing better than eating fresh, local apples when they are in season, and especially high quality apples, those being organic apples. As you may already know, apples are actually high always and score within the dirty dozen on the EWG's Guide to Pesticides in Produce. And so nothing beats fresh, local, organic apples. And so if you have the chance, either finding some at your local farmer's market or perhaps at a pick-your-own farm, or maybe you're extra lucky and you can find some wild, or perhaps you are growing some of your own apples. Wherever your apples are coming from, it is likely that during this season you can amount a large quantity of apples. And so what to do with them? Well, there are so many ways to eat our apples. Of course, the easiest way is just pick it up and eat it as it is. But you can also get very creative and keep the wholesomeness of the apple, as well as its nutritional integrity, if you structure your meal ideas, snacks, or recipes in the appropriate of ways. And that's where making some raw homemade applesauce can help. Normally, apples, if you have the right basement or cellar, should store well actually for months into the winter, and you can have some fresh local apples right into the colder months. Then I recommend tapping into them in small batches and making small batches of fresh, raw, homemade applesauce. As I shared with you in a previous video on how to eat apples, apples are outstanding sources of nutrition. And so we want to have them as part of our regular diet. But again, it's always best to eat our fruits, especially, as well as vegetables, as seasonally as possible. And so in that video, I shared with you all about the nutrition and health benefits of apples and how to maintain their nutritional integrity. And one of those things is to keep our apples raw rather than to cook or bake them, which really destroys so much of their valuable nutritional potential, especially when it comes to their vitamins, to their phytonutrients, to their antioxidants, and just in general, life energy potential. When the applesauce is in its most wholesome, natural, and high quality form, you can expect to get beautiful health and nutrition benefits that includes a wide array of healthy carbohydrates and fiber, a little bit of protein, virtually no fat, and lots of vitamins and minerals, especially, of course, vitamin C in its full complex of various antioxidant-based compounds, as well as other antioxidants, lots of healing and protective phytonutrients. And so all of these come together to help to enhance our health and well-being, especially when it comes to things like boosting our immune system, helping with our digestive system, especially with regular elimination, cleansing, detoxification, and just helping again with overall health and well-being. To make your applesauce, you will of course need some fresh apples as your main ingredient. And you can pick any variety that you like, any variety that you can really get your hands on or would normally enjoy. Aside from that, you actually don't need anything else. Anything else or any other ingredients are really just a bonus and can add a nice touch to your applesauce depending on what particular flavors that you'd like to bring out in your applesauce. Possible additions can be ones like wholesome sweeteners like dates or raisins. Try to avoid any kind of isolated or extracted sweeteners as much as possible if for any reason you do need to sweeten your applesauce. Other optional ingredients include some spices, of course, cinnamon being the main one, but something like cardamom as well as nutmeg or even cloves can make nice additions as well. Another optional ingredient is pure vanilla, whether you get it from the pure vanilla bean or some pure organic vanilla extract. You can also make all sorts of applesauce combinations with other fruits. For example, fresh strawberries go really well with apples to make a strawberry applesauce. Some people also enjoy making their applesauce a little bit more on the citrus side than it already may be. And so that's where some fresh lemon juice can also go a long way. And it also helps to reduce the discoloration of your applesauce if that is a concern for any reason. So those would be really the main ingredients that I would recommend to play around with in different combinations, as I'll be showing you in just a moment. Now, with regards to how many apples you'd want to work with, that really depends on how much applesauce you'd like to make. Usually I find that about 4 to 6 medium to large apples will make about 2 cups of applesauce. And that's great for about 2 large servings or 4 small or snack-like servings. If you would like to make more applesauce, then of course use as many apples as your blender or perhaps food processor can handle, and how much you can safely store for a few days so that it also does not go bad. In terms of the tools required to make some raw homemade applesauce, one of the first is to have a high-powered blender or some kind of a really good blender. Perhaps a food processor will do as well, but it all depends on your particular unit's ability and how well it's going to actually do the job to produce a really good consistency and texture, pretty much as you would get from the store, of your applesauce. Other than that, just a cutting board to prepare your apples, to core them, and some basic utensils like a spatula, spoon, maybe some kind of a dish to collect your applesauce, or some kind of a preserving dish, perhaps with a lid in which you can store your applesauce. So let's get started. The very first thing that you would most likely want to do, if you haven't already, is to give your apples a quick rinse. And I say quick rinse because if they are local, fresh, organic apples, then you really don't need to do too much work with regards to any kind of special washing. For your applesauce to be as wholesome as possible, you also don't want to peel your apples. You want to maintain the apple's wholeness and make sure that you're getting all the nutrients and benefits from the apple as well as the skin itself. Next, you want to cut your apples so that you can remove the core from the apple. Usually this will mean cutting the apple in half, then in quarters, and then removing the core, or perhaps you have your own favorite method of removing the core a different way. And then simply move these apples into your blender. And you can also give them a cut in half of the quarters so that it will be easier to process in the blender. Once you have your apples all chopped up and placed into your blender or food processor, you can stop right here without adding anything else, and it can be as simple as this. Simply process this. The apples themselves, that is, without anything else added, especially not thinking that you have to add any liquid. You don't want to add any water or any liquid whatsoever. And so this would be the simplest recipe possible. Just pure, whole, fresh, local, organic apples. If you have a particularly sour variety of apples or would like to sweeten things up for any particular reason, this is when you can put in some dates. It could be regular sweet honey dates or perhaps medjool dates or some raisins. And with regards to how much, you would go for about 1/4 cup or 1/2 cup of the dates or raisins. You don't want to overwhelm, as the apples are sweet, let's remember, right, on their own. So we just want to add a little hint of additional or different type of sweetness. And so for the applesauce I'll be sharing with you today, let's add in a little bit of raisins. And so here I have about 1/2 cup of raisins, so I'm just going to use about 1/4 cup, and that would be it. If you are going to be adding some other flavors, I almost always highly recommend that you add some cinnamon. And so when it comes to your cinnamon, as with all ingredients, hopefully you're getting a organic, high quality, fresh cinnamon. And then how much you would add will all depend on perhaps your personal flavor preferences or who you're making it for. For little kids, I would say err on the very tiny amount of cinnamon, maybe just a dash or so. But if you, for example, like myself, really enjoy cinnamon, then I recommend going for a significant quantity. So for the amount of apples I have here, I usually go for at least 1 tablespoon or more. And so by more, I mean usually somewhere in that 1 to 2 tablespoon range. And so I would add in that today as well. As I shared with you, you can also add other spices. I don't particularly enjoy cloves or nutmeg myself, so I wouldn't be putting it in my applesauce, but you can definitely experiment and try it in yours. I do sometimes add a little bit of organic cardamom, and I find that adds a little bit of a unique or different flavor. And so remember, you can play around and make as many different batches as you like. On a weekly basis throughout the fall, as you have your apples perhaps stored away, you can try and make as many different flavor combinations as you like. And so today we'll just be adding a little dash of the cardamom, as it tends to be one of the stronger types of spices that you don't want to overpower your applesauce, as that will definitely ruin the flavor. And as I shared with you, you can also add in some pure organic vanilla. And sometimes I add it and sometimes I don't. So today we're going to leave the vanilla out. And that would be it in terms of my most usual ingredients and the ones that I particularly recommend for your, especially first few batches of your homemade applesauce. So at this point, all we need to do is put the lid onto the blender and process it away until a smooth and uniform consistency is reached. And our applesauce is all done, and so at this point I recommend transferring it either to individual dishes and serving right away, or you can of course still transfer to individual dishes or just keep in one dish and chill for a few hours, or you can just store the entire amount right after you make it in a sealed container in the refrigerator for when you may be ready to use it. And so there it is, so quick, easy, and simple. As you saw, just a few minutes of getting your apples ready, putting them into the blender or food processor, adding in any additional ingredients as you may like, and you have a full flavored, a full bodied applesauce that I guarantee you will be one of the best applesauces you will ever taste, because nothing beats this type of freshness. You will also notice that the color is quite dark, especially if you're used to the typical store-bought applesauce, and that will predominantly depend on the type of apples you have and the fact that you're using them with their skins. That will definitely add that color to your applesauce. And of course, next to that, just the natural browning process of the apples as well. And so you can enjoy it as is, or you can add in some of your favorite nuts or seeds. For example, ones that go really well are walnuts or pecans, or cashews or almonds. Hemp seeds are also fantastic and also go really well with the applesauce as well. And so again, here's another way and idea for you to experiment and enjoy not just different flavor tones of the applesauce itself, but different additions to it as well. And so today I'll be adding in here, I've got a quarter cup of cashews. And so adding those in. Aside from eating it on its own or with some nut or seed additions, you can also add your applesauce to other meals. Meals, of course, that would go well with something like applesauce. And particularly here, I'm thinking of any hot cooked grain bowls, especially ones like oatmeal. You can make, for example, as you can see here in this image, oatmeal covered with some applesauce, and for example, another fresh fruit like a banana on top. You can also add applesauce or eat it alongside with quinoa. It goes really well with that, or some fresh raw buckwheat and similar grain ideas as well. And in terms of storage, typically you would want to eat your applesauce within 3 days. It's not that it will necessarily go bad after that time, but it's just that you want to, again, get the most out of your nutritional and health benefits here. Otherwise, with each day, there's more and more of a breakdown of the nutritional goodness of the food itself. So within 3 days is sort of the target date, but generally aim to consume it as fresh as possible. And because it's so quick and easy, there's really no need to make large batches, as within a few minutes, every few days, if you want to have applesauce on a regular basis, you can make some fresh, which would be best, so that you don't have to rely on any store-bought, pasteurized, or heat-processed applesauce. And so I hope you enjoy making your own raw homemade applesauce and getting creative with its unique flavor and meal or snack idea variations. And just to share with you again that, you know, with the right tool, such as a high-powered blender, you're going to get such a smooth, almost like a velvety, creamy applesauce. The flavors, again, are so full-bodied, just of the pure, fresh, wholesome apples. And then, of course, any other of the additions just bring it out that much more. So I hope you enjoy making your own, and thank you for joining me for this Healthitarian Living episode, and I'll see you next time.